Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky was greeted by a rare standing ovation from both parties in Congress Wednesday morning.
I'm proud to greet you from Ukraine, from our capital.
Speaking through an interpreter, Zelensky asked Congress for more help, requesting once again that the U.S. and allies establish a no-fly zone over Ukraine. But realizing that probably won't happen, he asked for an alternative of anti-aircraft defense systems to protect Ukrainians from Russian attacks.
The loss of life is staggering, the loss of livelihoods, the loss of homes.
Minnesota Congressman Dean Phillips was in the room when Zelensky spoke, but he says it was Zelensky's two-minute video that affected him the most.
I can tell you I've never seen so many colleagues with tears in their eyes and with hearts that are bursting.
Phillips says the situation in Ukraine has brought both parties together in a way he's never seen before. But while there's an overwhelming need to help, he says Congress and President Biden have to balance the risks of escalating this war even further.
Our first objective is to protect Americans, to protect the homeland, and we will do so at any cost. Secondly, it is a responsibility to lead the free world in the fight against tyranny.
So for now, Phillips says America will offer help from afar, giving Ukrainians the tools they need to stand up to Russia.
The American people are helping not just Ukraine, but Europe and the world to keep the planet alive.
Now, there were several moments in that video that were just too graphic for us to show on TV. Images of families and children who are now suddenly finding themselves in a war zone. Ukrainian news sources say that as of right now, at least 103 children have died during the invasion.
Gordon, thank you. Coming up shortly on Nightly News, hear more from Ukrainian President Zelensky. Lester Holt has an exclusive interview with him following the meeting with Congress.